Hi everyone, I'm Mike.
And I'm Thespi.
And today, we're going to talk to you about a bizarre but completely true part of history.
Spy cats.
Yes, the true story of how the CIA tried using cats to spy on foreign leaders during the height of the Cold War.
This is going to be exhilarating.
The story goes that in the mid-1960s, the CIA's Directorate of Science and Technology was looking for a way to conduct surveillance on a foreign head of state. They were inspired by the fact that cats were allowed to come and go as they pleased during the specific head of state strategy meetings. Cats were not paid much attention as there were a bunch of feral cats in the region.
Cats are elusive. They're slinky, they can get wherever they want. But you notice a cat. You see it walking around, you're like, what is this cat doing here?
Have you ever been suspicious of a cat, Thespi?
Every time my cat and I connect eyes, I know that all secrets of the universe trapped in his tiny little skull. Not many, but they're there.
I don't think I would be as suspicious of a dog.
Dogs are there to make people happy. Cats are there to plug away at your insecurities over time. I genuinely do think that cats have ulterior motives, which is why I wouldn't trust a cat to be a spy.
Right, and we'll get to that, because that is relevant. It's unclear who came up with the idea of spy cats, but from those observations mentioned earlier, the idea was born and became known as Acoustic Kitty.
Bum, bum, bum. Or should we say, meow, meow, meow.
Hate you. Since it was the 1960s, recording technology didn't allow them to isolate certain sounds, so recordings contained ambient noise that made it difficult to hear conversations. The theory, according to one source, was that because cats have cochlea, like humans, they would be able to filter out the unnecessary noise and focus on the voices they were targeting, and it seemed like they were actually able to condition the cats to listen to human voices.
When my cat and I lock eyes and we're holding them, and I'm seeing the vast emptiness, there's something going on in there, but I, as a human, cannot get there. How could you look at lots of cats and go, oh, we're on the same page?
I think there's a lot of, dare I say, misplaced confidence.
Were all these people men who were running this program?
You know, it was the 60s.
Most likely. Interesting, interesting.
Once the CIA had the idea, they had to execute it. However, designing an implant that contained a microphone, antenna, transmitter, and power source, and that was virtually undetectable by the animal, and would not impact its movement, would be difficult.
I am so terrified about where we're going. If we're like, look, kitties can't have little robot collars that clearly look like walkie-talkies where they're communicating with intelligence.
How cute would that be, though?
I can see a cat, I can see a thick collar, I can see it looking industrial, I can see, like, Austin Powers, Dr. Evil Lair vibe. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about secret, hidden spaces, which means they're gonna have to do stuff to the cat to get the things inside of the cat.
But this is where it gets a little dicey, and oh. Like, some people aren't gonna like this very much.
Okay, warning to all the kitty lovers out there. Know that we don't agree with this.
Eventually, they figured out placement throughout the body. The microphone was positioned in the ear canal. A 3/4-inch transmitter was placed at the base of the cat's skull, where its scruff provided ample space, and a very thin wire antenna ran from the transmitter through the cat's fur. The placement of the batteries to use as a power source is not apparent, but obviously had to be small, which restricted the length of recordings. According to a trainer, ultrasonic sound, not audible to humans, was used to guide the cat's movements.
As someone who tries to walk their cats, putting my cat in a harness is already a dangerous enough excursion.
Both dummies and real cats tested out the equipment before the team was ready to use it for real. Officials weighed the potential bad press for using animals for this sort of project, if word were to get out, against the potential benefit, and they decided to proceed with the project.
The dummies, little cat shapes, and they're like, okay, this is what it would look like on the kitty model. Someone else is like, hey Bob, you think this looks a little sketchy? And then the other guy was like, actually Bob, I think it looks good. So they're doing essentially a Venn diagram, and on one side is stopping Cold War, and the other side is people who like animals. And they're trying to find an intersection for what would be okay, and is this worth it? And clearly they were like, we're okay with this.
Finally, the day came for the official implantation of the recording device. The procedure itself took an hour as a group of onlookers watched a vet open up a female cat with gray and white fur. The cat was asleep, by the way.
I would be horrified if the cat wasn't asleep.
It's said that one audio engineer asked to sit after seeing the animal cut open.
I'm surprised nobody fainted. Wonder what the cat's name was.
Me too.
Like, are they cutting up Mimi?
It is a female cat, so. According to Victor Marchetti, the executive assistant to the deputy director of the CIA, the implantation went as follows. They cut the cat open, put in batteries and wires, and used the tail as an antenna. He said, quote, they made a monstrosity.
So you see here, what you do is you cut the cat open, you put the batteries and wire in, and you just use the tail as an antenna. It's just as easy as that. And then in the meanwhile, like, there's the Dr. Frankenstein onlookers in the background going, we've made a monstrosity. And like, imagine poor little Mimi, she's like getting sewed back up on the table, right? Imagine coming out of it and just being like, what the god, green earth, have these fucking other giant cats done to me?
As she recovered, the system proved to work. But some tech they had placed to control the cat's movements, which had previously succeeded, didn't work with any reliability. After she recovered, tests proved disappointing. While the cat could be directed small distances or in places it was accustomed to, it did not overall work well outside in the real world. As we'll soon see, ultimately the risks of a rogue spy kitty overruled the possible benefits.
What was that Hilary Duff movie? Agent Cody Banks.
Right.
That scene where he's getting all the spy toys and he's like running around and they're like, okay, here's your cool skateboard, here's all your things. I like to think of little Mimi running around the CIA and they're just like, Mimi, come back. And she's just trying to pick up signals, but she's also a goddamn cat. So she's like, what am I even doing here? I'm so confused. So poor Mimi is just trying to bust out of there and find a new life. So of course it's not working.
The hubris is wild here.
They should have taken a moment, predict the future, and they should have been like, in 2019, the world's most important movie will be released, Cats, where humans will be designed to look like cats. And they should have held out, and they should have controlled Rebel Wilson as a cat, as a rogue operative spy.
This is brilliant.
This is what dreams are made of. Not to keep going back to Hilary Duff, but like, anything is possible. This is possible, it's wrong.
However, the implantation of the recording device was still considered a win as it was operative. The cat just wasn't as controllable as once thought.
I can totally imagine going to a meeting and be like, look guys, can we not control the cat? Yeah, but we're getting signal, so we at least implanted something correctly.
Managers like to spin things.
I would do the same thing. I'd be like, guys, we're missing out on the silver lining, which is we could put wires in anything.
Marchetti also observed that the cat would walk off the job when hungry, so they put in another wire to try to override that. Finally, they decided to deploy the spy kitty for real. They took it out to a park bench and said, listen to those two guys. Don't listen to anything else. Not the birds, no cat or dog, just those two guys.
Is it like when parents talk to kids and they squat down real low and they're like, okay, Mimi, and they hold up like the two pictures and they're like, you see these two guys? That's who you're gonna listen to. Again, knowing that cats understand no English.
According to Marchetti, they took the cat out of the van and a taxi comes and runs the cat over. There they were, sitting in the van with all those dials, and the cat was dead.
Oh my God. Did Mimi just die?
It's very abrupt.
That's a lot. Like, poor little Mimi, finally outside, finally trying to break free, finally trying to do something. And then just like that. Can you imagine how much time and money they have invested in Mimi and her brethren to make this happen?
However, in a lecture given at the International Spy Museum, CIA historical advisor Keith Melton discussed the mission of Acoustic Kitty. He claims that the cat was in fact not run over while crossing the road and lived a long, healthy, and natural life.
Keith is 100% lying out of his bum. Again, this is like Victor going in the room being like, look guys, this didn't work, but this did. And Keith is in a lecture being like, I don't know guys, look at this happy gray and white fur cat. And they've just like deep faked Mimi's face onto the other cat.
Oh, it's like when a goldfish dies and the parents buy another
like,
goldfish.
Yeah.
I don't believe this. I wanna believe it.
Yeah, but like, this is the CIA, just acting like nothing's wrong.
According to Victor Marchetti, this project took 5 years to design.
Can you imagine sinking 5 years of your life into this? Like, I know there wasn't LinkedIn in the 60s, but like, how are you plugging in your resume?
And according to an interview with Marchetti in British newspaper The Telegraph, the project cost over 10 million pounds.
That's like a lot of money in US dollars today.
Correct. I mean, it still is.
It's still a lot of money.
So much money.
To spend on like doing terrible things to cats. Victor must be schwitzen.
So, what have we learned today, Thesby?
Justice for Mimi, a true American hero.
Gosh, I wish the CIA had watched Don't F*** with Cats.
Seriously,
You don't f with cats.
You don't. Clearly none of them had ever seen or spent time with cats. Not enough cat ladies in the CIA.
That was their problem.
Could have solved all of this.
We're thinking of Mimi. We know that's probably not her real name, but like, it might have been.
She could have been.
I will say this has kept me very entertained. I've been horrified, I've been entertained, and I hope you as the viewer have been too. So let us know in the comments what weird things from history we should talk about next.
Also, tell us if you've ever trained your cat to do literally anything. Well, thanks, Mike.
Well, thanks, Thesby. This was fun. Until next time, and hashtag justice for Mimi.